Divine presence, presence of God, inner God, or simply presence is a concept in religion, spirituality, and theology that deals with the ability of God to be present with human beings. According to some types of monotheism, God is omnipresent, hence the rabbinic teaching, the divine presence is everywhere.
Put God first, Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment.
I'm gonna just keep singing this song over your life, man. Is that cool? Bless you, bro. Let me just say, more favor coming your way. Oh, very soon. You believe in me?
God makes the statement in Leviticus chapter 10, verse 3, that's a universal and eternal decree. He said, by those who come near me. Yeah, draw near to God and he'll draw near to you. But listen, by those who do come near me, I must be regarded as holy. I'll never forget one day, I used to struggle to get in the presence of God. One day in my prayer closet, I didn't sing, I didn't pray, I didn't say anything. I just thought about the awesomeness of my daddy. I thought about the fact that he put the stars in the heavens with his fingers and called everyone by name. I thought about the fact that he weighed every drop of water on the planet in the palm of his hands. He weighed the mountains in his scales. And all of a sudden, there's the presence of God. And I went, whoa. So the next morning, I thought, I'm going to try that again. Happened again. I said, whoa. Next morning, I said, I'm going to try it again. It happened again. So the third morning, I said, Lord, I don't get it. I have struggled so much to get in your presence before in prayer times. It's so easy right now. And the Holy Spirit said, how did Jesus teach his disciples to pray? Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed, oh my gosh, hallowed be thy name. There it is. Jesus taught his disciples to come into the presence of God with reverential fear.
God will find you. Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment Perfected Faces done by Candy.
See, I didn't find God in the church. In fact, I didn't find God at all. He found me. He met me in a place where I was so broken, I couldn't get up. And when you're loved like that, it will shock you.
Whoever needs to hear this, listen now. God did not bring you this far to leave you. He did not bring you this far to... The scripture says that he that started a good work, he's faithful to see it through till the end. The work that the Lord has started in you is a good work, and he will surely see it through to the end. He says he makes all things work together for good for those that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. You did not find God, contrary to the way it explained today, that I found God. You did not find God. God was not lost. You was lost. God found you. And so if he finds you, he is big enough, strong enough and able enough to secure you and to keep you. You've got to believe that. In the book of Matthew chapter 6, verse 44, it says, no one can come to you unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day. Christ is saying that if the Father did not send you, if the Father did not send you to him, you will not be able to know him. So God found you. So you've got to believe that if he found you and he's brought you this far, then he's faithful enough, he's able enough, and he's more than willing to see you through to the very end, because he does a good work. He doesn't do unfinished business. No. The Lord finishes his work perfectly. The book of Ephesians 2 verses 10 says that we are God's masterpiece. We are God's masterpiece. Listen to these words. Created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared for us a long time ago. So before you were even born, there was a preparation for you. You've got to believe that, because it's true. Before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you. I'd set you apart. Right? So there's a preparation for you. There's a plan for you. There's a purpose for you. There's a path for you. and you are a masterpiece that is going through to perfection. You will be perfected. You're going through a process that is going to take you to perfection. The Lord did not bring you this far to leave.
God wants to be pursued. He's a relational God. He's a jealous God. He wants your heart. He wants your devotion. He wants your passion. In fact, he gives us an incredible promise in Jeremiah 29, verse 13. He says this, God says, you will seek me. And what happens when you seek me? When you seek me, he says, you'll find me. It's a promise. If you pursue God, he will reveal himself to you. You will seek me and find me. When you seek me with all your heart, God says, I will be found by you, declares the Lord. When you draw near to him, when you pursue him, when you crave him, when you hunger for him, God loves to be pursued and he loves to reveal himself to you.
To speak to people about a peg. So when you look at a peg, Sister Lerato, there's this silver spring in the center.
Yes.
A peg cannot function without the silver spring in the center. If I remove the silver spring in the center, it'll be just two pieces of planks that mean nothing. Same thing with your life. If I remove God at the center of your heart, you'll be a meaningless person. You wouldn't know your purpose. You wouldn't know your calling. You wouldn't know who you are. Number two, when you hang clothes on a line, why do you put a peg? You put a peg so that impacts zinga with zinga gold. Same thing with your life. Why do you receive God in your life? You receive God so that you don't fall into depression, anger, anxiety, bitterness, jealousy. That is why you need God in your life, so that you can be who you are and know your identity and purpose. Number three, if I remove the clothes from the pegs, impahla zonzakala zizohole. So that is why it's very important to stick onto the Lord. Number four, Apex does not discriminate, Sisley Rad. It doesn't matter whether you are rich, whether you are poor, whether you are filthy, whether you are dirty. Apex's job is to hold him back. It does not matter who you are. Apex is going to hold you. Isn't this is the same thing that God says, come as you are. It doesn't matter how broken. It doesn't matter what happened in your life. God is saying that just come as you are. Right now, during this lockdown, there's somebody that's broken. It's saying that, I have no future. There's no hope. But I want to tell you, God is saying, come as you are. And the word fear, Sisley Rato, the word fear, this word, fear, it has two meanings for me, Sisley Rato. It says, first meanings from the enemy. And people will say, forget everything and run away from the promises that God has for you. It's saying forget. But I want you to turn it around today. I don't care what situation you're facing today. Turn it around. Face everything and rise. I don't care what situation you've been through. A lot of people, they might have thrown stones. Like, dogs do not bark at a car that stands still, but dogs bark at a car that's moving. So what I'm telling you, run, hustle. It's difficult. Today I'm an author, Sisley Rato. My friends, when I shut my
wish you could trade eyes with me. Because there's complexities in complexion, but your skin is glow like diamonds. Dig me like the earth, you be giving birth to everything alive, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural. Same skin that was broken, be the same skin taking over. Most things are to focus you, but when you're in the room, they notice you. You in all of your glory. Your skin is not only dark, it shines and it tells your story. Keep dancing, they can't control you. They watching it.